What happens if you don't pay your taxes? That's what we're going to talk about today. On April 1st each year, if you do not pay your taxes, you automatically become delinquent and a 3% penalty is added to the taxes. If you don't pay your taxes, going on from there, we're going to talk about the next steps. But you eventually could lose your property in a tax deed sale. And at that point, that's when you actually lose your all your rights to your property. Somebody else has bought it through the state because you didn't pay your property taxes, because you are deemed to know that you have to pay your property taxes. The homeowner doesn't pay their property taxes, the overdue amount becomes a lien on the property, and a lien effectively makes the property act as collateral for debt. So when you get a mortgage, the whole point of that, it's a secured instrument saying if you don't pay your mortgage, we're taking your house. That's what a property tax lien is. It's the same thing. Now, since you haven't paid your property taxes, state can come in and take your property away from you. Once there's a lien on your home, tax collector can sell that lien at an auction. And that auction is called a tax certificate sale or a tax lien sale. So this isn't the tax deed sale. This is the first step. So your bill comes out November 1st. You don't pay it. April 1st, you get a 3% penalty. From there, the tax collector can sell that lien for that year at a tax certificate sale or a tax lien sale. If you don't then pay off that tax lien sales or tax certificate, then the next step is that tax deed sale where you actually lose your property. So let's get into the tax certificate sales. Florida statutes require the tax collector to conduct a sale of tax certificates beginning on or before June 1st for the preceding year of delinquent real estate taxes. Tax collector auctions off tax sale certificates. So what does that mean? So April 1st, you become delinquent. By June 1st, that tax collector has to sell that, or they can sell that property tax lien for that prior year. So let's talk about you don't pay your taxes for 2020. Your bill's going to come out November 1st. You don't pay it. April 1st, they're delinquent. By June 1st, the tax collector can sell that 2020 delinquency. They're not selling the property. They're just selling the debt. Tax certificate is a lien on property created by payment of the delinquent taxes due and is not a purchase of the property. It is literally you are buying a piece of paper at a tax certificate sale and saying, I now owe this debt. And we're going to talk about why people do that. So how does it work? And this is where we're going to see little variances between different tax collecting departments. Really, who they use as an auction site is different. If you're interested in buying tax certificates, tax certificate sales, every county on their tax assessor website has all the information on how to do it. And it is pretty much across the board the same in terms of timelines. It's just they might vary on payment and things like that. So when June 1st comes around or before June 1st, tax collector is going to have an auction on the internet for all the delinquent prior year taxes. The winning bidder is going to pay the taxes, interest, and costs and charges the lowest interest on the debt. So this is sort of a different, you're not the highest bidder, you're actually the lowest bidder. It starts off at 18%, so the tax collector puts out on the auction site this delinquency 18% interest. Whoever bids the lowest, and so it can go down to like 1%, is going to win that bid. And once that person bids the lowest on the interest, they receive that certificate of lien that they now own that delinquency. And they have the right to collect the tax debt from the homeowner plus that interest that they're now charging. There is a homestead exemption if the homeowner owes less than $250 in delinquent taxes, and the homestead is a homestead exemption. The lien can't be sold at a public auction and will issue the certificate to the county. So more than likely, delinquent taxes are going to be more than that, but this is, you know, a sort of a safe haven for people that have a lower tax rate. Tax certificates don't last forever. they last for 7 years. And as long as there's no other like bankruptcies and other proceedings that file it that may extend it, you have a 7 year period as a tax certificate holder to do something with it, essentially. And that's just a tax certificate. So any tax certificate that's issued, but before a tax season application is made, where there are no bids on it, it goes to the county for collection. And all tax certificates to individuals may be transferred at any time before that tax deed sale or redemption. So as a tax certificate holder, you're holding on to this piece of paper that says, I now own this delinquent property lien on this property. And there are a couple of things that can happen. We're going to talk about redemption. The next step is tax deed sale. So during that time, they can do whatever they want with it. They can transfer it to somebody else. But as soon as we get to that tax deed part of the process, all bets are off. And the homeowner or property owner can redeem at any time right now. They can redeem any time during the tax certificate sale, when the property taxes are delinquent, all of that good stuff. It's when we get to the actual tax deed sales when now they're cut off. One of the first things they have to do as a tax certificate holder, though, whoever bought that property delinquency, they have to file a tax deed application. And there are some rules for that. The tax deed application gets the ball rolling for the actual tax deed sale, which now the property owner's going to lose their house. They haven't lost their house yet because they've just, you know, the tax certificate holders just bought that debt. So if taxes remain unpaid, the certificate holder may file tax deed application within 2 years, up to 7 years after the date of delinquency. So they have to wait 2 years from that date of delinquency before they can start, they file that tax deed application. It's the first step in the process of bringing a property to sale at a public auction due to unpaid real estate taxes. With the tax deed application, the certificate holder is going to have to pay all the outstanding taxes along with an application and title search fee. So when the tax certificate holder buys at the tax certificate sale, tax lien sale, they're just paying for that 1 year of debt. Now, we're 2 years down the road, there may be two additional years of debt. Basically, that tax certificate holder has to make the county whole again, so they're paying off everything in order to sell the property at tax deed sale. After the tax deed application has been filed, it takes about 3 to 6 months for a property to go to auction. So as a property owner, if you have a delinquency and your property's gone to tax certificate sale, you have on average 2 years, 3 months, 2 years, 2.5 years before you actually may lose your property. You're still incurring interest and debt though. That doesn't stop because now that tax certificate holder that maybe bid 13% is collecting that 13% each year. Once a tax deed action is started, all the outstanding taxes at the time of application are rolled into one amount due, and that must be paid in full along with any accrued interest, costs, and charges in order to stop the tax deed action. So if I, as a homeowner, am like, I'm in delinquency, tax certificate holder bought it, I just have to pay off that 1 year to release that tax certificate. If it goes through this tax deed application, because now the tax certificate holder's paid off all the other delinquencies on your property, you as a tax or homeowner or property owner have to pay everything off and make that tax certificate holder whole. So if you're 3 years delinquent, you're going to be paying 3 years delinquency in order to redeem your property. But it has to happen before the actual tax deed sale occurs. You have really up until the date of sale to redeem your property. Tax deed sale, it's a public auction where properties are sold for unpaid real estate taxes. And this is where you lose your property. So tax certificate, let's just go back to the beginning. November 1st, you get your tax bill. March 31st is your last day to pay. April 1st, you don't pay it, you automatically are in delinquency with the county. It's a 3% penalty. By June 1st, the county is going to sell that debt to a third party at a tax certificate sale. That third party is going to bid the lowest interest rate, get the tax certificate. Now they're the ones that are collecting the debt, essentially, if you need to pay it off. If within two years you still haven't paid it off, the tax certificate holder can file a tax deed application, which gets the ball rolling for you to, at this point, as the property owner, lose your house in a tax deed sale. No redemption, you can't get it back.